Hello everyone, in this video I'll show you how to enable the data layer in the WordPress website. If you want to enable the data layer in WordPress site, then first you need to set up Google Tag Manager and connect with your website. And if you don't know how to create a Google Tag Manager account and how to connect with your website, then we can watch my previous videos. Also, you can check out the description. I will put there my previous video link. How to create a Google Tag Manager account and how to connect Google Tag Manager to the website. Now I assume you have created a Google Tag Manager account, and let's see how we can enable the data layer. Before enabling the data layer, I think we should check whether your website has a data layer on or not. So how you can check it? Just go Google and search data layer checker. So I just search here data layer checker and click enter, then you can get this page. Just open it. So I need to click here, add to Chrome and add extension, and we should pin this extension here. Okay, so now if I go our website and if I scroll down here and visit any product page, and if I click this extension, then see you can see here is no any product page data layer show, because we need to enable data layer. Then we can see here product page data. So if I click any add to cart, so we can see here is no any data. Sometime here take some moment, so you have to keep some patience, and then you can see here is no any view item data. So what actually we need? First we need a plugin. The plugin is totally free, so first you need to go your website dashboard, I mean backend panel, admin panel. Then you can see here is plugin option, and just click add new plugin, and you need to write here plugin name. The plugin name is GTM 4WP and search. Then we can see this interface, and we need to install this plugin GTM 4WP, a Google Tag Manager. So I have already active this plugin, but you need to install this plugin and active, and then when you active this plugin, you can see Google Tag Manager settings from dashboard setting section. So you need to click this Google Tag Manager option, and then you have to put here your Google Tag Manager ID. I already made video about it, how you can connect Google Tag Manager with your website, so you can watch my previous videos. And for this tutorial I will show you how you can enable data layer. So when you click here, then you can see this type of screen. Then you have to click integration option, and then you can see here is WooCommerce option. Just click here, and just you have to select two options. First is track e-commerce, select this one, and then scroll down, you can see there is another option, order data in data layer. Just click this one and just scroll down and save and change click. Now we can see our data layer is enabled or not. So if I go our website again and refresh this page again, then we can see our data layer is working or not. Okay, we need to wait some time here, and then if I click this extension, then we can see actually my net is slow, that's why here take some moment. See here is view item data layer. See, there is lots of data available. So we can track e-commerce tracking. See, So if I go to Google Tag Manager and click here preview mode, also we can see here our data layer is enabled or not. So I just show you, click preview mode and then click connect. So our Google Tag Assistant is connected. Now if I go product page, now we can check from Tag Assistant. See, here is our view item file already, and if I click data layer, then you can see here is product data, item ID, item name, price. So if I click add to cart, then we can see again add to cart tag file here. See, add to cart. And now if I click data layer option, then you can see here is everything, here is data, product data. So we can set up e-commerce tracking, and we can copy this option for trigger. And if I click view cart, also if I purchase this product, we can see here every event file here, and we can copy event name and create tag trigger variable, so we can track any event in our website. See here view cart event already fire. And now in the next video I'll show you how you can track e-commerce tracking through Google Tag Manager. Okay, thank you for watching this video.